Yeah, I know exactly what you're talking about. I can't remember the name of it.
No, I played it so much. This is embarrassing. This is what Pet Nat does to you. It ruins your recall. Well, exactly. If you can't remember. All right, what was your wine of the lineup then? Guys, welcome back to another episode of Wine for the People Blind Wine Tastings. We're doing something a little bit different for a really long time. We've been doing 6 glasses of wine at a time, but we're switching up the format a little bit this week. We're gonna try and condense these videos down, give you really action-packed notes, which is something that we're famous for. So we're switching to 3 wines per week. Let us know what you think of that. If you hate it, if you like it, let us know in the comments. That's not the question for this week. The question for this week is marry, kill. Pinot Noir, Riesling, Chardonnay. All right, so for me, I think this is controversial, knowing me, but I think I'm gonna marry Chardonnay because I think marriage is something that's a long-term commitment, and for the next 30, 40 years, I think I'm really gonna grow into drinking Chardonnay. Unfortunately, that means that I'm gonna have to kill Riesling because I think that if I've got a side piece of another white wine, that's gonna cause problems in my marriage to Chardonnay, which means that I can have this fun flirtatious thing with some little French Pinot Noir, which I'm really into if you ask me, but let us know in the comments down below. Also, huge shout out to our new partners, Different Drop. We've been going with them for a little while now. They're setting us up with these brackets that are all themed in some way. We haven't been given any hints on the theme for this week, so I've got no idea what we're about to get into. Having looked at them, I've got a vague idea, but like, if you want 10% off any of these wines, we've actually got our own collection page on Different Drop. So if you head to their website, go to the Wine for the People collection, you can get all the wines that we taste on the show at a special discounted rate. And I'm not gonna lie, based on how it's been going so far since they've been supplying us, they're all pretty yummy. So head over there and have a look. But for now, let's get into wine number one.
So there's no hint this week, but looking at the three, it looks like there might be a bit of a theme here. So we'll try the first one.
Eyeballing, I reckon the theme might be like Pet Nats this week, might be my idea, because they all look cloudy and bubbly and fun.
Nice and like, yeah, peachy, like nice kind of like nectarine peachy stone fruit thing.
So definitely some kind of sparkling. It's a little bit funky, some really cool acidity. I think what I like about this wine is it tastes like it's been intentionally picked to be made into sparkling. And sometimes these sort of styles, I'm guessing it's probably a Pet Nat, not a classic sparkling wine. They can look a little bit too ripe, but this has a really nice line of acidity.
This tastes like flavored mineral water to me. Like it, oh, I actually like this more than some other Pet Nats because some other Pet Nats get this sort of like, it's almost like waxy or lanoliny or something going onto it that just gives it a little bit of funk. This one's actually pretty clean, which I'm about.
Mm. It's got some grit to it. It's got some like really chalky mouthfeel here, which is really quite appealing. Acidity is lovely. There's a nice saltiness. There's a nice kind of like pear-like thing. Reminds me of a wine that Unicozella makes, the Seafun.
Maybe a little bit of barrel work, but generally super enjoyable wine. Super yummy wine, really refreshing. I would probably take 4 bottles, and I'm thinking maybe $28.
And I'll have three. And this is, it's probably suffering from being the first wine, and I'm seeing 2 pinky red boys coming up, and I'm really excited to get into those. It's nice, but it's just not perfect for me. It's lovely.
Number 2, rosé looking thing, like very coppery, very like orange, salmon, all the good stuff.
Really fragrant, a little bit spicy. I'm not too sure what variety this would be. Again, it looks like a sparkling or some kind of Pet Nat.
Narrator's voice, it was the one. This slaps, oh my God. It does have a slightly, has a slightly savory finish on it, which I wasn't exactly expecting.
Really interesting, very perfumed. I'm not massively into this style. I think I'd get sick of how just like fistfuls of flowers and perfumes of it. I don't think I'd drink more than like 1 to 2 glasses.
Oh man, these are hard to pick. A little bit of a savory finish. I'm probably a bit too savory for me, but nonetheless a good wine. Quite enjoyable.
Bubbles give you this nice little spritzy thing in your tongue. So like the whole, the foaming, like you put a Mentos into a Diet Coke and it starts bubbling up. It's obviously not doing that in my mouth, otherwise it'd be coming out of my nose, but.
I think it's probably a bit more. I think it's more like $40 because there's a bit of interest here. This might be like an import. This might be from Old World, but very interesting. Yeah, that kind of like very perfumed floral thing. There's a nice kind of like blood orange tang, but interesting little wine and definitely something off the beaten path, but not exactly something I'm looking to drink all the time.
Wine number 3, more bubbles, more Pet Nat. That is the color of a peach lolly.
Very brioche-y, Very, very brioche-y and nice kind of like red fruits, like red currants and raspberries and stuff like that. But it looks delicious.
Smells delicious. It's got this like underripe strawberry on the nose and then kind of this like fresh tomato on the palate, which is really, really cool. I'd have to say this is a pet nat. It's got quite a lot of lees, like a lot of yeast character on the nose and on the palate coming through as well.
These are all so typical of that pet nat style. Like it's not, I want them to be a little bit sweeter. I want them to be a little bit more like lolly-like, but they're a little bit more serious than that. So if you're actually a grown up who likes drinking real wines that don't, but if you don't like a vodka cruiser, you'll like all of these wines.
Yeah, heaps good. Tastes like Pinot Pet Nat, A-T, so P-E-T-N-A-T. That's what my sheet spells now. But these are all pet nats. This one's my favorite. I'm happily paying $35 for that. Bang, love this. Pinot Noir style pet nat.
Yeah, it's got some nice lazy characters, giving it good body. I would probably take, yeah, like re-looking at this wine, it is actually really tasty. I'll take a six pack of this. I actually think Brendan would really love this wine too. And it's probably again around that $35 mark.
30 bucks again. Like these are, actually no, 38. I haven't guessed 38 this week and it probably will be. And I'll take three of that one as well. So number two is the pick for me, but I'll be very interested to see what Laura and Noah have to say. Before we get into talking about these wines, I had a punt at what the bracket might have been this week. Did you guys have a go?
Yes.
Yeah. I mean, just by looking at the colour in the glass, the variation.
Burgundy, right?
Old world. I know, pet nat, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, of course.
Cool, thank God, because yeah. I did a lot of pet nat chat there, so. Yeah. Cool. What'd you guys think of wine number one?
Reminded me of sea farm. Chalky texture, love that kind of chalky, salty acidity. Very, very tasty. For me, I just want to make an Aperol spritz with it. It's like turbocharging Aperol spritz.
Like tasting it fresh with the bubbles in it, I was just like, you know those cans of slightly sparkling, slightly flavored water? It was like that sort of energy for me. Like it was limey, it was citrusy, it was all these things. I had it for 30 bucks.
Yeah, 28.
32.
And I wanted three bottles.
I wanted three, two.
Four. Niche. Love it.
That's what we want.
Look, how much was it?
Cool. Okay, yep. In the bracket where we like to see it. Brave new wine.
Man. WA producer.
Yeah, Great Southern. Vermentino Riesling. Vermentino is the same base as Seafoam. And which is always known for salty, and then that acidity is from Riesling. Wild fermented, classic thing. Just all the standard things, no sulfur, no nothing. But yep. From Great Southern 2022. They make really delicious pet nats.
Nice.
Great labels, great people. Number two.
Wine number two, breakup juice. What did you guys think of it?
Breakup juice.
Yeah. You've just gotten through like the really sad part of a breakup and you're like, I need to go out and have fun. Drink that.
I thought it smelled like Cate Blanchett. I'd love
to know if you're right.
It's so perfumed, but it smells like sandalwood and like really fine perfume. So I was just like, it reminds me of like a bus. Like it's like a Dior ad and it's like Cate Blanchett or Natalie Portman selling you this perfume. Yeah. And that was my thing with this wine.
And the whole like, when they're making those ads, you can't really tell people what it smells like. So you just have to be sort of like really ethereal and like, this is the whole vibe.
Yeah, Laura, I love the aromatics and I actually really like that extra savory element to it.
Cool. Lucky.
And actually, when I went back after the tasting, I was thinking as a category, pet nat has become quite affordable.
Yes.
You know, when these were first coming out like 5 years ago, they were $35, $40. And now you can get some really good value ones.
Which is good. Yeah. Which is good. We got a jumping juice. Jumping out of your cave, listening to the Killers and getting out of your breakup bowl.
I'm telling you.
I think that's really good value for what it is. My Japanese wine company, Lenswood.
Just around the corner. The sort of pet nat that I really like, where it is just like fun, it's got a cool label, it's a nice pretty color, it looks good on Instagram, and it's just, like, it's just all of the things, like what you said, it's the thing that wine industry needs that sort of like fun frivolity rather than just sort of like, here's a $100 bottle of Chardonnay, you should play Uno while you drink it sort of thing. Like that's not how you appeal to young people, this is how you appeal to young people.
Yeah.
It's good shit.
At Penfolds.
Wine number three. This is a grown-up cruiser.
Yeah, really fruity.
Really fruity, really fun. Not quite as sweet as just like your traditional guava watermelon sort of thing, but like still all those flavors.
I said $35 again. I wanted six of this.
Yeah.
It had a bit more body to it, a bit more texture, and it's got that kind of yeasty lees thing, which I liked. And it shows the style that it is such a natural sort of wine.
This is what I call variety. I reckon this is Pinot. It's got this Pinot thing to it, like this kind of like savory, like earthy thing around that like really fresh fruit.
I wanted three of them for $38.
I wanted half a dozen for $35.
And you wanted 35 for, you wanted six.
I wanted
for 35
for $6. Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's what I wanted.
I think we all want that. Come on. $6. Come on, Lucky.
39.
Okay, fair enough.
Stick to six.
I think you can give this at a better price point, to be honest. And it is Pinot Noir.
And it's from Tasmania.
Dr. Edge.
Well cold. Really well cold.
But yeah, this is Dr. Edge, one of, we've had his wines on the show many times and we've raved about every single one of them.
Yeah.
And once again, we're raving about his bloody pet mat, which is called Dr. Ongo.
Dr. Ongo.
Drongo.
Drongo. Oh, man. What was that Bethesda video game, Dishonored or something? Like you can jump around with like a mask and things like that. That's what the label is.
I know exactly what you're talking about. I can't remember the name of it.
No, I played it so much. This is embarrassing. This is what Pet Nat does to you. It ruins your recall. Well, exactly. If you can't remember. Alright, what was your wine of the lineup then?
Drongo. Absolutely.
Dishonored! Cool, yeah, I'm happy to go with
Democracy.
You guys.
Drongo, once again, Pete Dredge, I think, continues to have the record for most wine of the weeks on this show.
Yeah.
Unstoppable. I reckon I'm going to drink that now.
All right, we'll be back with three more wines next week, guys. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll catch you then.